rear bumper, driver door, front bumper.
Oh! Get off!
Rear bumper. Passenger side. I doubt I can reach it from here. If I could reach it from there from the other side, then I doubt I can break it from there.
I can't reach it from here!
I just have to climb onto the top.
How do I... trying to. Oh, there's one. This one's an easy one to get to.
All right!
Nicely done! Now, aim the thing toward the receiving dish!
I'll try, but it's getting a little bumpy out here. I can't talk to her from here.
Use the arrows and click around and drag them around.
Flames.
How am I gonna get to the roof?
I can't reach it from here!
I just have to climb onto the top!
I was able to climb in from the
it's
front,
up.
But I kept walking. I should have stopped. Come on, Marty, you could have stopped. Run by.
Marty!
I'm okay.
Don't cross those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing.
Close, Mr.
Your fusion's belching flames!
Yes, that's unfortunate. I'd stay out of them if I were you.
How am I gonna get to the top?
It's one of the flux emitters!
To the top. Passenger door. What do I have? Is it on Mr. Fusion?
Not sure what that'll do.
Why is it not letting me climb up to the top? Come on, let me climb to the top. Front bumper.
I can't talk to her from here.
Windshield wiper. There we go.
This windshield wiper sure came off easy. I thought DeLoreans were put together better than that.
Plot device. It's all because of the plot, Marty.
Nice work, Marty.
Rear bumper. Driver side.
I
sure what that'll do.
Front bumper.
Made it.
Excellent. Now let's get that bloody supply mouse wall before she starts making life difficult.
Oh, we broke her.
She's
we broke her mirror. That's
now?
Why. We broke her mirror. That's why she wasn't able to see us. That makes sense. What's over us?
Here goes nothing, Doc. Whoa!
Perfect! Now, aim the focusing towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
On it.
Receiving dish. Check!
It's really hard to control. I guess it's a lot harder with a moving vehicle. Come on, stay put. Got it. One more. To get up on the roof.
We're almost home, Marty. Just one fuck seat left.
Get off my car, you hooligan!
I can talk to their headman now.
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Ah. Nice, I made it to the top. Oh, I didn't
Marty,
make it to the top.
Marty, are you alright?
Not really.
What?
Pull over!
No!
Whoa!
Perfect.
Excellent, Marty. Now that you're on top of the board, you can attach the flux sink to the overhead flux emitter.
That's great, Doc.
Hoverboard.
It's stuck.
Great.
Don't worry about the hoverboard. Let's get that last
one. But the hoverboard is amazing. This is a very awkward angle. This is a very awkward camera angle of being. There's a lovely angle of Marty and his crotchular area. Great, perfect. Okay, you know what? We're gonna go ahead and finish this.
Ha! Nicely done! Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish!
Alright. Fluximeter, upside down. It's actually a little tricky. Come on. It's tricky. Alright. I think I might have gotten it. Come on. Oh my god. This is real. The controls for this is frustrating. Okay, come on. Got it.
That's it! Get out of there, buddy!
But the hoverboard is stuck still. There we go. Marty! Okay. Now there's two DeLoreans. So what
now
are we gonna
do? Now we take control of Evan's DeLorean with the flux and crutches. That's strange.
Good news,
what?
Doc.
According
good news.
To the treaties, the temporal cohesion of Evan's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home now.
So yeah, let's do it.
Hold on.
Right into the police station. Oh boy. Now what's gonna happen? And we still have the grandpa problem.
Parker? Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
Wow. No! You can't arrest me! Not now, I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are.
Oh, boy.
I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it! Unhand me, you dolt!
I see a ship between the two of them. Maybe that's who she'll end up falling in love with.
I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate.
So it's not
by my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
So it's
what the hell? Hey, Parker! You're not gonna believe this!
See? What I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc! The timeline's not fixed yet. Look! Harry, you missed all the fireworks at the expo. Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! Marty took me to Reno last night!
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
Marty, you can't do this. You're not supposed to get married for another 5 years.
Well, I know Trixie and I were taking things slow.
But after that witch Edna got me fired with that postcard, we kind of accelerated things a little.
Oh, God.
The postcard? Oh, man. This just isn't right.
Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
What's gonna happen to Marty? Am I fading out?
Can you see through me?
Nope, never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
That is Sylvia Miskin.
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did
you? Got
ya?
It.
Don't
I knew
feel
that.
Too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. You're Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
Nice.
But you're so... so skinny and blonde.
Huh.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing.
Oh my God. I've seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
I said that Trixie's
okay,
probably
pal?
Not her real name.
I'm
called
fine.
That.
Great.
Way
you
back
kids
in the
go
first
off
episode.
And have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around.
I was saying Trixie Trotter has got
come
to be her
what?
Stage name. That's what I said.
To approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides,
I got a look
as
at
my
her.
Dear old father Seamus used to say. No sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
Yeah, it's about time we ended that.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Callahan.
See you in the funny papers, Harry.
It's Corleone, but whatever.
Goodbye, Grandma.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
So everything is hopefully back to normal. Hopefully. Come on, game, you didn't put one over on me. I called the whole thing about the arsonist and
here we
I
are,
called the
good old
Trixie and Sylvia.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale?
Nice.
You mean... Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for? Yeah, I sure did. Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov? Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists?
Oh, sweet. He's living in the present.
Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you. Happy graduation.
Graduation? But that's not for another... The McFlies of Hill Valley.
Wow. An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather, Seamus, to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931, to look for her.
Exactly.
That's...
Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy on her stage name?
I knew it.
This is great,
this guy here.
Thanks.
It's the least I can do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Edna! Edna! Not in jail anymore.
Einie!
What's going on? What are you doing at my door?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much-needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
I think she ended up shacking up with
Cannon. Dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
I called it, sweetie.
Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
Oh, Biff, I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh, gosh, you're right, Mr. McFly. Hi, Marty.
Hi, Biff.
Don't they make a great little family?
You'd never know they met in prison.
Oh, yeah. Yep, I saw that coming. Come on, Telltale, you gotta
Don't
do better than
anything.
That.
Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
I want to see Clara and the kids. They're probably not going to show us Clara and the kids, but oh well. And everything is back the way it should be. Oh no, now what? What now?
Doc!
Marty! What are you doing here?
You gotta come with me! Back to the future!
What?
You can't be here! If your younger self sees you, the consequences
it's
could
too
be
late.
Catastrophic.
My younger self? Oh, right. Bring him along, too. This
what?
Concerns all of us.
What
do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Nah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids?
What the hell?
Great Scott.
This is amazing.
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Back to listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you wanna save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What?
That timeline was overwritten 5 jumps back.
God.
Jennifer's out of
How can there be two more of me here?
I have no idea. My own rights of space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rag right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up. And you gotta come with me to save it. No, me.
Oh, this is amazing. What?
So, we meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands. Or three.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real
they
me?
They all are.
Isn't it obvious, Marty?
They all are.
Come on.
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait. What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future and mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
Oh, that's amazing. Yes, and just like in the movie, you didn't see the people in the car. Just like in the movie, the people in the car disappeared, but that's okay. Wow, that was amazing. Oh, that was such a great way to end that. Oh, I love this music. Oh. All right, I probably should try talking over this though, because, yeah. But this game was an amazing, amazing nostalgic ride with so much fan service. So much homage, so many homages from the movies. I picked out a few, and I'm sure there's a bunch of other, like, little Easter eggs that pays homage to the other movies. The attention to detail, again, this is why Telltale is so great, is because when they come up with a project, the developers themselves are huge fans of their material. Many of the developers are. They know their material, and because they're huge fans of it, they know how to fan service people up to the wazoo, you know? And they're able to include little things in the game that makes you remember and appreciate, you know, all of the stuff from the movies. Like, from, you know, the thing with the wallet earlier, and, like, that the whole ending of that sequence was all, you know, making fun of the first movie. So, just for that alone, I thoroughly enjoyed this game. So, one thing I'm going to tell people is, if anyone is a fan of this movie, you really need to play this game. You would be doing a great disservice yourself if you didn't experience this, because it's just a great way to come back to this story, come back to these characters in this universe 25, 30 years later, you know? So that's like the good stuff about it. The bad stuff about it is, you know, it's like I said, a lot of the combat is a little hokey and a little bit non-believable. It didn't seem like things were as dire. There were parts of it, like, there wasn't as much of a sense of urgency. I mean, it's not like The Walking Dead where, you know, you have a split second to make a decision, otherwise dire things happen to you. There's no game over. There's no game over screen in this game. It's very forgiving. You might argue it might be too forgiving, but it's good for people who are not hardcore gamers and might need a game that's more forgiving. It's more accessible, I guess, to a wider bunch of people, and that's not a bad or horrible thing. It's meant to be a fun game, you know? It's meant to be fun. And I think it is fun. The dialogue, you know, Marty, of course, Joey LoCascio, I think his name, who voices Marty, so amazing, so spot on. Did such a great job with Marty. Ooh, the Michael J. Fox Foundation for Parkinson's Research. I love you, Michael J. Fox. Love, much love for Michael J. Fox. Such a beautiful, beautiful man inside and out. It's a great way to just relive my childhood, because I like I said, it just brought me back to when I was 8 years old, or however old I was when I first saw the very first movie. To be continued, there's no, like, question mark. I mean, it opens it up for Telltale to continue on. I don't know if they will make another Back to the Future game. Probably not, but it's kind of nice that they added that as a just in case kind of thing. Other constructive criticisms that I'm trying to think of. Again, there was the whole thing with the dialogues. choices where they didn't really seem to matter. If you chose, there were four distinct dialogues, and if you choose one, Marty ended up just saying the exact same thing, no matter what you pick. That was a little bit annoying. But fortunately, like, all of these criticisms, like, this Telltale as a company has, and their games, have improved and addressed a lot of those concerns that I had, you know. And this is back 5 years ago, you know, before The Walking Dead, before Tales from Borderlands, before The Wolf Among Us, before Game of Thrones. And I mean, comparing this game to the games that they are now, you can see that they learned, and improved upon their craft. So, yeah, I mean, yes, the warts are there in this game, but at least it's nice to know that that Telltale has, you know, addressed and has addressed and improved upon, I'm pretty sure, every single wart that I just mentioned. The story itself was, I mean, it was a good story. I thought it was a good story. I have had better. I mean, I think that there were stories that are more engaging from, again, future Telltale games. But like I said, this was 5 years ago, and even though it was about 5 years ago, it's still, I think it's still a solid game, even for being 5 years old. The other thing that I think I wanted to say, what else did I want to say? It also was too bad that your saves didn't really, like you, none of the decisions or dialogue or choices or things that you did really affected anything else. It was a very linear story. There weren't like choices to be made, and you didn't load your previous saved game onto a future episode. Again, that all got improved by Telltale Games now. But yeah, it was, I greatly enjoyed it. Like I said, Miss Strickland, I think the thing that Edna was just such a really annoying character. Like there were times when you love to hate her, but for me personally, there were more times when I didn't even love to hate her either. She was such a frustrating character. And at times, not in a good way. For me personally, she was not a frustrating character in a good way. There are plenty of other stories where you've had frustrating characters, but you loved to hate them. It was frustrating in a good way. Like for me, for example, Dolores Umbridge. Dolores Umbridge, horrible, horrible character, but good character in the sense that I love to hate her. I love to hate her. She was such a well-designed character, and it was fun to hate her. Edna, there was just times when it just wasn't fun to hate her, and I think part of the problem was Telltale would try to make you sympathetic towards her. They would try to make you feel bad about her, and then they would turn around and make her such an ugly person again, like an ugly person. They kept fluctuating. It was like this roller coaster of first you kind of understand Edna, then you don't, then you despise the woman, then you sympathize with the woman, then you despise her again. And this just was very emotionally disorienting. And it wasn't, for me, it wasn't as enjoyable. But it still didn't completely spoil the game for me. And I mean, you needed a villain, you needed an antagonist, and Edna was definitely a major antagonist in addition to the Tannins. Things for me got very predictable near the end. There was a couple of twists that I sort of saw coming from a mile away, but that's okay. It was still, I guess the fact that I thought up of those twists, you know, gives me a chance to pat myself on the back. I was very happy about that. But yeah, that's what I have to say about Back to the Future, the game. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. And, I miss this movie so much, and I miss this universe, and I miss these characters, and I love. We'll always have an undying love for Michael J. Fox. And thank you again, Telltale, for bringing this back to us, for giving us a chance to continue the story of Marty and Doc. And it was just so great to see this bond between them, the friendship between them. But, I mean, that was the theme. It wasn't just Edna. It wasn't the story of Edna. This story was the story of Doc Brown. You know, the Back to the Future trilogy was more of a story of Marty, with the exception of the third movie. The third movie was more about the story of Doc Brown. But this Back to the Future was, I guess it did fluctuate between Marty and Doc Brown. But for the most part, this was a Doc Brown story, and I think that's pretty cool. Would have loved to have seen Claire and the kids, but it's okay. I didn't really expect them to bring them. But hey, maybe Telltale will make another Back to the Future game in the future. Who knows? The future's not written in stone. It's not written yet, apparently, as they say. Thank you guys for watching, and until next time, love yourselves and love each other.